Good morning. We are here with Connect to Thrive Morning Reflections. I'm Jen Drakes, here with my co-host, Ciano Ivajlu, and we have a tantalizing topic for you this morning, tantric sex. So, Ciano, my darling, why don't you just bring us into this topic?
Oh my gosh, it's such a great topic and such a great way to start the morning. Tantra, you know, there's people that are familiar with it, people that are not. It's funny when people think, or if they have any context of it, they just think it's about some weird sex practice or it's all about sex. When really, Tantra is one of the highest forms of yoga. And it's not always a sexual practice. It's a spiritual science with an aim to transform consciousness to realize enlightenment. Really the freedom from suffering. So there are many different types of yoga, a lot of different offshoots. You could go from the Tibetan, Taoist, Neo-Tantra, but it's all basically rooted from Hindu and mostly from the Osho teachings. And like there's even African sacred sexuality. So there's a full domain of tantric modalities out there.
Is my understanding correct that it was created by two women?
Well, the lineage I study under mostly is a Dakini lineage, which is rooted from the teachings of two women, which I'll get into. So I find it so important to educate people about sacred sexuality because it could really take relationships to the next level of intimacy. And really in the world where we're in right now, where you know, disconnection is so prevalent. You want to know tools and resources that you can bring back home, especially to your relationships, to foster intimacy with more intention and consciousness. So Tantra is about connection. It's about connection to self. It's about connection to others and transforming the consciousness to experience this enlightenment. Okay. So the more we discover our true nature and heal all our blocks, we're coming back into our natural essence of who we truly are. Tantra, the word itself, literally means weaving light and sound through form. And form is being the physical body, light are the visualizations we use, and sound are the vibrational mantras that we say as well. So it's creating this catalyzing healing relationship between the mind, body, and spirit. Authentic Tantra is one of the more potent holistic and sexual practices that I incorporate with my clients. And it's rooted in the Tibetan five element Tantra teaching. So it's a holistic healing modality that has five pillars of methodologies that we use. And that's from movement, pleasure, meditation, connection. And it's meant to balance, enrich, and heal the physical, mental, emotional, spiritual body from the inside out. The specific lineage that authentic Tantra comes from is the Shangpa Kagyu lineage, which is the Dakini lineage, because it was founded by two women, Sukha Sidhi and Naguma. And these powerful women achieved full realization and enlightenment and passed down their teachings through oral instruction and at times initiated their disciples through tantric sexual union practices as well.
Several times you've used the word enlightenment.
Yes.
What is enlightenment? When you reach that, how do you know you've reached it? What is that?
As humans, I don't think we ever truly reach full enlightenment. But, you know, it's the space of the integration of the body, mind, spirit, and sex.
When these things come together in an individual, meaning it's all balanced, you're comfortable in all of these types of modalities, because I look at them somewhat like modalities, and they're all aligned. That's when you have reached that kind of ultimate like peak.
When you have all these, as you say, modalities in harmony, it allows you to realize higher states of consciousness. And for me, the enlightenment is around those higher states of consciousness and awareness that we can live into, right? Tapping into greater forces and energies that, like, you just feel this freedom from suffering. Like, you know, it's like things can happen to you and you can still hold
things together. You can still hold yourself together. I kind of look at it because you remember we had discussed about me, I'm learning all about the neuroscience piece.
Yes.
To me, it is changing the percentage of how you're functioning at the subconscious level to more the conscious level. So the way you describe it in that teaching, most people operate at 90% subconscious level. and only utilize 10% of their conscious. But there's a set of society that has been able to change those percentages, meaning they have moved some of the percentage from the subconscious to the conscious. So they're operating at a higher conscious, you know, level. In my own teachings, from that perspective, that is when you, I call it, you're kind of ascending, right? You're more aware of a different level of consciousness. Yeah. And you're able to withstand the hits of life much better, because that subconscious kind of gives you a lot of misbeliefs, you know what I mean? And creates totally wrong stories.
Totally.
So when you're operating at that level, you're completely in a different hemisphere, if I could use that word, than most of, I wouldn't say, you know, all of society, but most of society. So it seems like that's a little bit akin to the enlightenment piece. It's just when you use those types of words, I'm conscious of the audience listening, but not quite grasping what that is, or even how they know if they're getting there.
And I love how you reflected your own experience of it, because it's great to see the different perspectives or the deepening the conversation on that topic alone, because people have different experiences of it. And when I hear you say, you know, what you've shared about consciousness, it really makes me think of, like, it's not about what happens to you, what happens for you.
Exactly.
Like, able to see everything as being in service to your evolution, and being able to see the appreciation of the experiences of this life. So it's such an important piece to bring into the conversation, because it's the consciousness that allows us to have a greater relationship to our experiences. And intimacy is one of them, right?
Yeah. And it also brings you to a greater movement towards truth. You come to realize that subconscious level, not deliberately, but just the way it functions, it is creating lies, right? And you start to buy into those lies. And that's how you get limiting beliefs. When you get to the conscious level, you're closer to truth.
Mm-hmm.
And you're closer to seeing and controlling the stories that are going on in your head. So you're living a more truthful existence than when you're not. So moving those percentages is really our own evolution. And what we should be trying to do is operate at a higher level of consciousness. So I love how these different teachings, and even how this conversation, the audience can look and go, okay, I'm learning this. Oh, this makes so much sense. And now that teaching is in Tantra. And it's another way to explore that side of yourself.
Totally. There are so many different paths to enlightenment. People just have to find what resonates for them, that they're bought, you know, and sometimes it's dabbling into different things to take you to your next level. Mm-hmm. Like for me, this work was a huge evolution for me, getting into a deeper relationship with my sensuality, my sexuality, and really dissolving the shame and guilt that we have as a feminine species around our sexuality and sensuality. And, you know, it's interesting, when I first started doing this specific modality of work, it was like I spent about 2.5 years training through this, and I rejected it at first. I'd sit in these meditations because it's rooted in the 5-element meditations, and you're sitting there meditating on these elements, the fire, air, earth, water, space. And, you know, my focus was off. Like, I'm like, what the? She's like, you know, my teacher would be like, this is medicine. You know, like, we're actually healing ourselves from the inside out. And it was a challenge for me. Months would go by and I'd tell me, I'm frustrated. This isn't working. That is not doing anything for me, right? Like, I'm not feeling anything. And then she'd be like, Kano, tell me what's happening in your life, right? She's like, what's happening in your relationship? And I'm like, oh, well, I've got like really good boundaries with my ex, all of, you know, like it's really shaping and I'm able to hold ground. She's like, oh, okay. What's happening with your health? And I'm like, oh, well, actually, you know, my immune system's been stronger. I've been able to fight off, you know, things easy. Like, it feels like they're kind of just passing through. They're not sticking. Oh, what's happening with your work? Like, so she took, and then she'd be smiling at me, and I'm like, what? Right. She's like, that's the work, Tia, you know. That's the work, right? She goes, it's about what's happening in your life.
It's working.
Right? Here I'm expecting to feel like these vibrations and these things. And look, eventually over time, when I just stayed with it, I would start to experience more internal sensation, or just be able to feel energy moving. But it took me a while. So that's where I have you know, a lot of patience with the people I work with in that journey of saying, yes, the resistance, we're all used to the quick fix. Give it to me now, give me the results and I want that big shebang. Well, this is very much about the slow and the steady, which ends up being a beautiful art that you translate into every area of your life.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk about that in terms of why women would seek Tantra versus men versus couples. So why don't we talk a bit about going out and seeking that truth, seeking that enlightenment?
Well, many women, they seek it to heal sexual trauma. They seek it, they want to experience orgasm or multi-orgasm. Many, women in their adulthood have never experienced, and they're just like, is it even possible for me, right? They want more inner peace and harmony. We want deeper connection with their relationships. They want to magnetize a higher quality relationship in their life, and they also want to pursue sexuality as a spiritual practice. So these are some of the reasons women start exploring or coming into this work. For men, very similar in terms of the healing trauma, wanting to last longer, wanting to be better lovers, also wanting to learn how to master their sexuality in terms of separating orgasm from ejaculation, and also for sexual dysfunction. Like this work is very beneficial for erectile dysfunction or premature ejaculation. And also, again, for wanting to create deeper intimacy with their partner or take it mm-hmm. to the next level, or just really understand how to communicate in a sexual manner more confidently. Like there's a lot of confidence that comes around mm-hmm. through this work. And then as couples, it's they come because they're feeling disconnected and want resources and tools to know, like we're not taught intimacy. Right? Mm-hmm. We have very distorted measures of what intimacy is. Like in a lot of couples that I work with mistake affection for intimacy. Like they'll be like, oh yeah, we get along. We have a good relationship. Mm-hmm. We talk well. We say what we want in the bedroom. And then I'll take them through some exercises.
Yeah, that's not necessarily intimacy. Yeah.
Yeah, to show them the difference between affection and intimacy. And it can mm-hmm. simply be through like eye gazing or how they're directing each other for with their desires. And then they're actually like, oh my God, I had no idea, right? And it just starts awakening a different pathway again. Some people are wanting to use their sexuality as a healing practice because you can actually use a lot of this work to heal trauma, to heal emotions held in the body, to heal this. So there's many different practices I work with couples on how to, let's say, do mapping on the genitalia area to provide healing, releasing through the work.
We're challenged as a society with that. And I think one of the things is also the religion versus there's a lot of religious teachings that move us away from that sexuality recognition and appreciation aspect of ourselves. I'm taking it because at one point I had heard sexual wholeness was mm-hmm. kind of what Tantra does. And is the wholeness just taking in the whole aspect of us as a human being that has like sexuality is a massive part of our identity. And so is that wholeness accepting that identity as just being part of who you are? And being able to embrace it a bit more? Is that the sexual, when we use the term sexual wholeness?
Well, yeah, like when I talk about sexual wholeness, it's about using the whole mind, body, spirit, and sex, right? Okay. Like all parts of ourselves. But in today's day and age, sexuality is the cause of so much pain, right? In the practice that I use, like the instruction, we approach sexual connection with mindfulness and how to use energy for healing and spiritual growth, because it becomes vital with each passing day. Like this is our life force. And, when we're disconnected or shamed against the essence of what we're created in, like you need to have sex to be born, right? And yet we're shamed around the expression of it, right? Mm-hmm. So the teachings I work with address the critical role that sexuality plays in being healthy, whole, and an integrated human being and bringing mm-hmm. those into alignment with each other.
How does someone begin? If someone's interested in exploring and in those teachings, I'm interested to explore, like how you mentioned, there's all sorts of different ways to get to enlightenment. And I find I have a piqued interest in all of these sort of different ways of touching this subject. So for someone who might be interested to explore this, how would they begin?
Well, first, like there's many different modalities, as we talked about earlier, out there. So it's first resonating. And because it's such an intimate and personal experience, I say, don't try to do it alone. It's great to have guided practice, especially as you're beginning into this, because stuff comes up, right? Mm-hmm. And you want somebody that can hold that container for you, you know? But if you're just like, okay, I want to explore, really, Tantra, as I said, it's about transforming consciousness. That's the beginning of Tantra. So when we're starting to put more connection to ourself and more connection with ourself to the outer world, we're already starting to practice an element of Tantra. When we want to bring more intention around that, you know, something very basic is, you know, creating sacred space. Okay. And this is like using all of our senses to activate our environment. Right? So we're getting completely in tune with the taste, touch, smell, you know, hear, you know, elements in the space that we're in. So like, how is the lighting? Is there music playing? You know, if I'm eating something, am I taking time to take in the flavor and pause and, you know, like swirl it in my mouth or chew it where I'm really like absorbing the texture? Mm-hmm. Am I somebody or am I by myself? And how am I making that time conscious, right? So even all these, that in itself can take your experiences to a whole level from ordinary to extraordinary. I have a handout of just ways to create sacred space. They're just wonderful cues. Like, you know, you're by yourself and you just want to create some more conscious time. Like even me, like I've now gotten so ritualistic with it. And there's something that is very healing in ritual for the nervous system, right? So in the mornings or when I'm doing, I have music playing, I have my lighting a certain way. I have, you know, making sure my space looks neat and tidy or in a way that makes me feel productive. You know, there's all these things that I just naturally now bring in to get, and I feel my nervous system get into its regulated zone.
And we also have an offer that we can present to the audience as well. Why don't we talk about that? We are offering exquisite sexuality for women. And because A Rays of Living is not just about women, I have to say that, Connect to Thrive is also not just about women, but men, if you are interested in this, you've heard Theanu talk about the benefits that men seek through Tantra. So if you are interested, please still reach out to devotion@thetheanu.com and we will create one for the men so we can have both an exquisite sexuality for men as well. But right now we'll be launching 4 sessions running exquisite sexuality for women, awaken, heal, enrich your body, mind, spirit, and sex. Please reach out to Theanu if you're interested and get registered. Was there anything else you wanted to talk about this course, Theanu?
I'm actually making it 6 sessions, not 4, because I want some integrative time that we can actually do Q&As to process the work as we go along. I've spread it out over 6. So if any of the audience here is interested, I would love to have them participate and join and support them through that.
And when you reach out to Theanu, just use the code TANTRICSEX to get some additional benefits associated with registering for that course coming through this medium. So just make sure to use TANTRICSEX when you reach out to get those benefits as well. On wrapping up, what are your closing words for the audience?
We get into mundane routine habits around sex. And, you know, I invite everyone to explore this modality to some context of how it could be truly medicine, a healing connection, really create a sense of greater joy, compassion, and peace within self. It's a wonderful modality to incorporate, even if it's just like some spice here or there into your life or in relationship, whether you're single, dating, or in a committed partnership. There's value to be experienced at every level. And really, it's all about doing the work with oneself to then extend it to the people in your life around you. So
And for me, my message to the audience is we are in unprecedented times. We have been forced to stop and look at ourselves and how we are interacting with our world and within our own lives. And so this is an opportune time to start exploring all these different types of teachings. And Tantra, in all honesty, is the only one I have seen that explores it from a level that brings in the sexuality aspect. Many explore the mind, body, and spirit, but not necessarily the sexuality aspect. And I think it is very interesting touch point for others to not forget that aspect of who they are and to bring it in so it's healthy, it's healing, and it's enriching for those they connect with. So by all means, reach out to Theano and start that exploration. We're always interested to get feedback and comments. And this show is all about bringing these types of topics at this level. And then the other thing with Tantra is the healing inward from inside to out. So by all means, jump on board. It has been a great time. Thanks for joining us with Connect to Thrive. Have a wonderful day and a wonderful rest of the week.